You're also your boy Kaggy, back at it again with another video. In this video, I bring you the tokens for Crypto Raiders. Ladies and gentlemen, I was not expecting this game to come out with a play to earn full tokenized economy. It is absolutely insane in my opinion. I mean, this game is so fun. At the beginning, this game, I really didn't like it. But then when I started playing, I was like, yo, this is kind of fun and this is kind of chill to play with, right? So this game is an AI RPG. So it's an action RPG, but it's AI. You don't actually control your characters. You go into dungeons and then you can find loot and then you can sell it in the marketplace. Now, the marketplace is still not out, but the tokens are coming out. So they have a governance tokens and they also have a utility token, which you can earn inside the dungeons. Also, those tokens are going to be airdropped. A portion of those tokens, they're going to be airdropped tomorrow, Sunday. If you own Crypto Raiders, you're going to get tokens. You're going to get tokens right into your wallet, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, let me actually give you an insight of how this game works. As you can see right here, I have 37 characters that I bought on initial mint. They do have a chance of dying on dungeons. So let's say I click on this character right here. I can go into a raid. We'll go into a raid right now. And of course, you go inventory. I've been into raids and I have found loot. This loot, you're going to be able to sell it on the market. And the appearance, you can change it right here. Pretty cool. I'm sure in the future, there's going to be more options. But you're going to be able to sell this loot in the marketplace. And of course, you're going to be able to find weapons and stuff like that. Potions, as you can see right here. Armor. And of course, tokens. That's what we're talking about in this video, of course. So let me actually go into a raid so you guys can see how that works. And I go into this raid. It's automatic. I'm not doing anything. At the beginning, I didn't really like it. But man, I really, really enjoy this game. I really enjoy this game. At night, I'm always like just clicking, doing my thing. And I just click another character until I finish my dungeons. In the future, it's going to be way harder. You're going to have to think more. You're going to have to actually strategize depending on the loot that you have. Because loot will give you different stats. So very, very important to keep in mind right there. Now, something very, very important, because these characters have a syncing mechanism, you're going to be able to mint more characters, right? You're going to be able to click and mint something like maybe Crypto Blades if you guys have played it. But the difference here is that they're actually going to have a system to know whether more characters should be able to mint depending on how many characters are being sunk per day or something like that, and how many people are actually playing. You don't want thousands of characters in the market, people clicking and minting characters, right? Very, very important. Now, these characters that I have are Genesis characters, so they're gonna be way more valuable for many reasons, right? One, because it's people like collectibles, and two, because in dungeons you have a 30% higher chance of actually getting better loot and more tokens and stuff like that. So very, very important to keep in mind. Right here, they have a medium article on the tokenomics. I'm not gonna go too deep into it. I'm just gonna give you a diagram right here. It's very, very simple to understand. It's something like Axie Infinity. Actually, you have the AXS token and then you have the SLP. One is a governance and the other one is a utility token that you actually use to breed and do certain things within the game. So same concept here. And let's actually use this diagram right here. As you can see right here, we got the ARM token. This is the utility token that you're gonna be able to use for different things within the game. As you can see, value creation, game activities. You're gonna be able to use it for dungeons, recruiting character, more value creation activities, crafting, enchanting, PvP. Now, this token can be earned by the player and player creates value with this token as well. And of course, you're going to use this token within the marketplace. So when you buy and sell within the marketplace, you're actually basing it on the ARM token. So it has a utility within the game. And then you have the Raider token, which is the governance tokens. If you guys don't know what a governance token is, very, very simple. It's a token that has extra abilities, I guess, within a game, right? It is a fixed supply. This token is going to be able to use for governance, making decisions within the game. So if you actually like the game a lot and you want to shift decisions and you want to have power within the game, then this is the token for you. Also, you're going to be able to earn by having this token. Once you stake this token, everything that goes through the marketplace has a 2.5% marketplace fees, and then that fee, a portion of that 2.5% of that marketplace fees actually go to the people that have the Raider token staked. Something like Axie Infinity as well. Axie Infinity has the same model with the AXS token. You actually stake the token when the staking actually comes out. And then a portion of the marketplace fees goes to the people that own AXS token. And that is why the AXS token is so important. So if this model works really good, we're in for a ride. Of course, not financial advice. I've been in this game way before, you know, I even knew there was gonna be tokens. I actually liked the characters, and I started enjoying the actual gameplay. And the fact that you can find loot and then you have this risk of actually dying and you're gonna have to strategize and stuff like that, that's pretty cool. So the fact that they actually introduced a token into this game, I'm excited for it. So if you own characters, you're gonna get a portion of the initial mint of this token. So very important. It's gonna be airdropped into your wallet. Actual floor of this characters actually went up quite significantly. So if we go right here to OpenSea, we can actually go buy now, and we can actually go low to high. We go to low to high. These characters are, I think they're not available. So the bottom right now is 0.22. I bought this at 0.025. So that's almost like a 10x on these characters. And of course, the value of these characters are gonna keep going up depending on the actual loot that you have. So as you can see, this purple robe, it's pretty rare. So if you buy a character with purple robe, you're buying like a rare item there in a way. Of course, we're in the beginning. These dungeons are like test run dungeons. So even though they're test run dungeons, this loot is gonna be very valuable in the future, because it's gonna be like one of those OG loots where people are gonna be like, holy crap, you were there from the beginning type of shit, right? Let me leave the link down below for this OpenSea collection. Very important. I mean, there's a lot of scams out there. There's actually a verified one. It's called Do Not Buy, because we actually transferred the crypto raiders into Polygon, and now we're in a different contract. So very important, do not buy from this contract right here that is verified. It has to be this one, crypto raiders characters. And I'm gonna leave this link in the description if you guys want to buy characters right now. So there you guys have it. I'll see you guys next video. Peace.